this week's episode of Naruto Shippuden, Sasuke's journey continues as he is joined by brand new companions, Chino and Nawaki, as they continue to try and find Fu Shin, the leader of the Lightning Gang who holds the secrets to the Kekkai Genkai ability of making ninjas explode. As if that weren't enough, it looks like Orochimaru has officially returned to creep up this week's episode. Get ready to place your bets, because in this week's episode, Sasuke and Orochimaru infiltrate a hidden island with a secret underground fighting ring. This week's episode was a lot of fun, continuing Sasuke's brand new story, which continues to be quite enthralling, I have to admit. It also helps that this was another great episode with great animation, artwork, and frankly, a pretty interesting and mysterious story. Not to mention, Orochimaru has returned, and he's going to play a pivotal role in this arc. He's going to be instrumental in helping out Sasuke and his brand new ragtag group of friends in finding out who Fu Shin is and how he is causing people to explode. So, what I love most about this episode is they actually address the fact that Orochimaru and Sasuke are like big-time ninja criminals, and the ninja world has been pretty lenient on them, allowing them to sort of have their very own personal freedom, with Sasuke going on his long journey and trying to rectify the wrongs of the world, taking on all types of villains, and Orochimaru, who he himself claims is not really free, and that's because he's under constant surveillance from, of all people, Yamato. That's right. There's a veritable who's who of classic characters appearing in this week's episode. Yamato, Suigetsu, Karin, and even freaking Jugo. Reminding you that you love these characters and you wish they could have spent more time with them. And honestly, I would have liked to see more of them in this episode. It just reminds us that, hey, they're still around, so that's kind of cool. But what's really interesting about this episode is that Orochimaru and Sasuke are going to be teaming up with each other, Sasuke reluctantly doing so. He doesn't really want to seem to work with anyone, including Chino and Nawaki. And what's the deal with Chino supposedly being older than Sasuke? Ultimately, what we can take away from the scene is that you can't judge people on first impressions. In fact, it all tied back to this lesson that Itachi actually taught Sasuke himself. And you know what? I like this. I like how that's sort of coming back to the forefront, and he's constantly remembering himself about all of the things that his brother taught him. But even with the sage advice from Chino and his dead brother Itachi, Sasuke continues to be kind of dismissive towards Chino and Nawaki, not even really talking to them all that much. They're basically just along for the ride, and they're definitely creeped out when they see Orochimaru. I mean, I think just about anyone would be if they saw the combination of Voldemort and Michael Jackson. But according to Orochimaru, he's going to be able to help out Sasuke because apparently this Fu Shin guy used to work for this guy by the name of N. Oyashiro, who is this arms trader who is also completely obsessed with Kekkai Genkai abilities. And since Fu Shin had that, he might have some information about him. The problem is, this guy's really hard to find. He even has a secret base, which is even more hidden than Orochimaru's, which I find somewhat hard to believe, but whatever. It leads to what I think is probably one of the coolest parts of this episode, where Orochimaru and Sasuke go to this hidden island, and it's basically like this big, swanky Vegas fighting arena. Like, they go underground, and there are all these, like, rich aristocrats who are fighting with each other, and they use their ninjas to go up against each other in the ring, and whoever loses, they actually get to take those ninja and put them in their crew. It's like the Davy fight back of Naruto Shippuden. Orochimaru, being the snake in the grass that he is, actually decides to enter Sasuke into this little tournament. And Sasuke is reluctantly going to have to go in when N. Oyashiro throws in one of his ninja, who is predictably going to get his ass handed to him. But before that fight can even happen, suddenly another one of those exploding zombie ninjas appears, which I'm sure is going to cause all sorts of trouble. So what's the rundown on this week's episode of Naruto Shippuden? Like I said, the most interesting thing about this episode is that Sasuke and Orochimaru are working together. These two villains, these two creatures from the dark, so to speak, are allowed to do things that the real heroes of the series can't do themselves. Like, this is something that Naruto would not do. This doesn't seem like the type of journey that he would be into. This is totally Sasuke-centric, and I really love it, especially because he's taking a lot of the lessons that he learned from the past and not fucking it all up this time, which I think is pretty damned impressive. He's a lot smarter and more caring about people than he ever has been in the entire series, despite the fact that he shows very little emotion. Orochimaru returning in this episode was also a pleasant surprise. I really like the fact that they emphasized that he's not really free himself. He's free to conduct experiments, which I'm sure there are going to be restrictions on those as well, like not actually killing people and using living test subjects, and the fact that Yamato is going to be watching him, which I think is poetic justice, considering that Yamato was created by Orochimaru. The tension between Orochimaru and Sasuke also makes this a really pleasant episode. You're almost expecting one of them to do something a little extreme, and it never really happens. You know, Orochimaru can't really do anything against Sasuke, I think, at this point anyway. Sasuke is just so incredibly powerful, and I don't even think we've ran into any villains so far that could even have a chance of going toe-to-toe with either Naruto or Sasuke, but maybe this arc will prove otherwise. Maybe this Fu Shin guy is just one hell of a badass and we don't even realize it. All of the stuff with Chino and Nawaki, though, I'm still not really sure what they're going to be doing with these characters. The fact that Chino is a lot older is interesting because it brought back that lesson that Itachi taught, but I wonder how, like, important she actually is going to be to this arc in the beginning. I mean, I still have the theory that she is going to be connected to this whole exploding ninja zombie thing. The only reason I say that is because we saw those flashbacks in the last episode of that girl who looks suspiciously like her, and, you know, you can't really judge anymore because we now know that this is a character who is older but looks a lot smaller, like a child. It's kind of like what is going on with Tsunade and Orochimaru, just like on a completely different scale, with Tsunade using her seals to make herself look younger and Orochimaru just living in the skin of other people. This could be some sort of other thing like that, but still, I can't wait to see how that's going to unfold. The next episode's preview makes it pretty clear that Sasuke's probably finally going to meet this Fu Shin character, but I can't wait to see what's going to happen in this underground fighting arena, which was just such a fun setting. Very different from anything that I've seen from the Naruto series. It almost seems like it didn't belong at first, but honestly, I liked it, if only for how refreshing it was from some of the stuff that we've seen from the rest of the show. Not to mention, there were a few cool action scenes, like when the ninja were actually fighting against each other. That's one thing that needs to be said about this arc so far. It still has some really great action, atmosphere, and most important of all, good animation and artwork, which just makes it all the more inviting for Naruto viewers. Not to mention, we're finally getting to see a side of Sasuke that we've never seen before, the caring dark hero, which I think is really awesome. Like I said, he doesn't display that much personality, but the viewers can sort of implant what he's thinking, like, while they're watching. You always know really what's going on in his head, and that's a really big accomplishment with animation, which I think made this episode work as a whole. That and the fact that I just think it's honestly a really exciting story, and I can't wait to see where it's going to be headed. I'm totally digging this brand new arc of the series, which is why I'm going to give this week's episode a 4 out of 5. There were a few moments which I think looked a little wonky, but for the most part, this was a super solid episode of Naruto Shippuden, which Naruto fans should definitely check out, especially if you did not read the novels that these stories are based on, because you'll be able to see them for the very first time. That's why I'm so excited about this stuff. I have no idea what's going to happen. I'm just really excited to see how it's going to play out. So there it is. That's my thoughts on the episode. Before you guys leave, make sure to tell me what you thought about it in the comment section below. Are you enjoying this Sasuke-centric story? Where do you think it is going to be headed? And what do you want to see from the rest of the Naruto Shippuden anime series? Thank you guys for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe. I will see you next time. And as always, stay dandy, baby.